following a tuk-tuk, and I'm in Melbourne. Mornington Peninsula. It's like a taxi service. So who would have thought there would be a tuk-tuk from Thailand here in Rye Beach? Check this out. What up, everybody? Hello again. Welcome to my channel. You gotta have a look at this. Hopefully you can see. I'm not sure if you can see in here. The border, the color of it, it is spectacular. So I'm just down in Rye at my parents' house this weekend, and every time I come down here, always try to make an effort of coming down to the beach before I head home. I was just up here for the day. Yeah, just helping the guys out with the cafe again. And I thought I'd bring you guys here. This is a cool spot in Portsea. I've got to show you the water. You don't need to look at me. I will take you there in a minute. If we go through here, this is like a little private, I think it's called the boardwalk. Most people who live down here, so we're down in Portsea, and most people who live down here know about this area. So there's like all these properties back up onto the right here of the cliff face. And what happens is, when they built this, they left this bit of land here at the front as council property. So as you can see here, there's a fence here, and then a fence here, then you've got the beach. So it's like a land in between the beach, and you can actually come along here and walk along all the beautiful mansions and all the big properties. Obviously more people know about this area than what I realized. Bloody tourists. But I mean, you could say I'm the tourist, but I'm just coming here. This is so pretty. I'm coming here just to show you guys how beautiful this country is. Got like a little private jetty. They can park up their boat, walk up their little own private jetty, store some stuff in that little shed, and they're at their own little haven, little beautiful sort of spot for their own property. I mean, if I owned this house, I probably wouldn't be too happy about people walking, you know, at the back of my property, but it's just the way it is. It's turned out to be a beautiful day, so you got quite a lot of boats out on the water. Is that a good view or what? Probably see the water behind me. It was just really shit weather this morning, and this afternoon it's just turned out to be an absolutely beautiful day. Not a cloud in the sky. So I thought, you know what, I've got the camera with me. I'm gonna take you guys to this little spot. This is pretty cool. Got this tree here. And they've cut the fence to allow for it. Look, this little A-frame to support it. Most of these houses people live in, but there is quite a few houses that are just rich people's holiday homes. Lucky bastards. See those guys down there? I think they're paddle sailing, paddle surfing, something like that. Hopefully you can see them. They're just in here. So then after tonight, as you saw in my last, actually if you saw in my last vlog, I went to the MCG. That was my last work event for the year. Boy, I'm glad that's over. So I got a few more weeks till Christmas, and then day after Christmas, which is Boxing Day, I head overseas. It's like in between. Manicured to the manicure. It is the grass of grasses. This is like the edge of the cliff face, but yeah, as I said, this little area you can come, and this is where this property finishes. Yeah, like another little ranch up here. This is where this property finishes, and then there's this little section, and there's a cliff. So it's funny how they've let this to the public. And this is someone's backyard, but they actually allow people to go in their backyard. And yeah, they haven't obviously, there's a fence here, and this fence I'm assuming would probably should run here, but they haven't fenced it, and they just obviously allow people to come into their backyard, but they just want us to shut the gate. So this mirror is just allowed here, which is just, yeah, a little bit strange, and but it's pretty cool. Anywhere else in the world that you know of that's similar to this, where houses back up to the very back of a cliff and there's the beach, and you're allowed to walk in between there and their property and the beach, there's a little pathway. Tell me, I want to know where else in the world is similar to this, because I think this is pretty unique. And look, the water. So if you know a place similar to this, write in the comments down below and yeah, let me know. I'd love to know if there's other places like this. This is just so cool.
Yes, I'd like to go into my mansion. Thank you.
I love looking at nice houses. It's one of my favorite pastimes. What does that mean when people say that? One of my pastimes. What, because they don't do it anymore? Answer that question for me. Yeah, so a couple weeks to Christmas, got a work breakup party. That's probably the last official function, but it's with my workmates. And then I get to relax. Really looking forward to Christmas. So Merry Christmas to everyone watching. So that's gonna come around bloody quick. And yeah, Boxing Day I fly off to Singapore, and really looking forward to spending 4 nights in Singapore. Then I head to Phuket, where I get to see another YouTuber. And I've mentioned him probably in almost all my vlogs. His name's Sunny. Check out his channel, Sunny in Thailand. He owns a restaurant in Phuket. Or just up from Phuket, the next beach up, called Kamala Beach. It's called Grill Bill. So I'm really looking forward to going there, and I know it's high season, so I don't expect to see much of him because he's gonna be flat out, but it'll be just an awesome experience to be able to go to that restaurant. And yeah, I've seen all these other people who follow this guy on YouTube travel there and meet up with him, and yeah, I'm really looking forward to being able to do that also. So a mate of mine, Bill, he's going to be in Cambodia and Laos, and hopefully we can meet up in Chiang Mai. So I go to Singapore, Phuket, Bangkok, then Chiang Mai for quite a while, about over a week, and hopefully I can meet up with him there. Then after that I go to Hanoi in Vietnam, and then after Hanoi I go to Hoi An for a few days, and then I go to, so this is Boxing Day, I start my holiday in Singapore, and then after Hoi An I go to Ho Chi Minh City for 2 nights, and then my holiday will be over. I'll be really sad, but super excited because I'm going away for 23 days. Yeah, a few holidays that I've had have always been about 13 nights, so this is a really big break for me. So really looking forward to that. I have been away for a long time before, and that was when I went to America, and that was for about 2-3 months, but that was back in 2005, so I'm really looking forward to this. So yeah, let me show you the private jetties. So you can see up here, you've got all the mansions. This one up here looks bloody awesome. I'm pretty sure this one here, it might look white on the camera, it's actually like a greeny colour. The guy who owns that, his name is Lindsay Fox. And anyone living in Melbourne, Australia, would know who Lindsay Fox is. Those of you who don't know who he is, I'm pretty sure he's still working, he's not retired. He owns the biggest transport company in Australia, I think, called Lynn Fox Transport Services, something like that. So all the big Coca-Cola trucks that drive around and deliver all the Coke, he owns all those trucks. And this is his holiday house. This is actually his own private little beach, believe it or not. With his own little private jetty, and I think the water actually comes right up to here. You can actually see where the water would come up normally, and you could bring your little boat up to here and you got your own little private jetty. I'm guessing that this old little thing with the wheels on it, if you can see it, maybe you put like a little boat or I don't know, a little suitcase and wheel it up to your back door. Now this guy who I was talking about before, Lindsay Fox, he must be here this weekend, because the way he gets to his property from Melbourne isn't by car, is not by water, but have a guess, it is by chopper. Can you see the helicopter? His own private helicopter. Mother Beeper. Yes, that's his property up there. Just, you know, park the chopper on the sand, no worries. So yeah, that's a chopper in there. It's just beautiful around here. So if you're rich, this is where you come. Don't worry about Toorak. Toorak's a very rich area in Melbourne. But yeah, it's just beautiful. I'm home. I'm joking. I wish. That house looks so nice that I want to drive into it. So what street this is in Portsea, to come to the back of the properties, it's a dead end, you park at the end and then you go, you will see how to get there. The street is called Point King Road, if you can see that.